Do you want to create a simple and interesting game that can help boost students' concentration? Get your students ready to dive into learning by playing Defuse the Bomb Game. In this game, students have to answer trivia questions in a limited time to defuse the bomb. If they answer any question incorrectly, or the time is out, the bomb will explode, and the game is over. Are you ready to explore how to create this game with ActivePresenter in just a few minutes? Let's get started. We will go through three main steps, including preparation, customizing layouts, and creating game. Firstly, you need to prepare two things. They are a list of trivia questions and media resources. You import those resources into ActivePresenter. To do that, in the View tab, click Resources. Then, drag the resources from your computer and drop them into the Resources pane. This manipulation can help optimize your time creating the game. You can select the image and audio objects from the Resources pane, instead of looking for them many times in the folder from your computer. We will move to the next part, customizing layouts. We use SlideMaster to create these layouts. In the Master Layout, deselect the Auto Advance option so that a slide won't jump to the next slide automatically when it completes. In the Title Slide Layout, set a background image. In the Question Layout, you can freely set the background image, font, size, color, and so on. Also, add the Go Forward action to the on-click event of the Submit button. And don't forget to create transition effects between question slides. Finally, you set a background image for the blank layout. After that, close Master View to save the changes. Let's move to the last part, creating game. In Normal View, you insert slides based on the layouts having been customized in SlideMaster. Access the Home or the Insert tab, click the arrow on the New Slide button to add 7 slide layouts. We add a title slide, 5 question slides, and an ending slide. Begin with the first slide. In this slide, you create a play button by opening the Insert tab, then clicking button. You can now style this button the way you want. Then, add the on-click event and the go-forward action to the play button. After that, we adjust 5 question slides. We add the question title and then set its correct answer from the list of questions prepared at first. Uncheck the case-sensitive option, so that the uppercase and lowercase letters will be treated the same. Then, you add events actions to the text entry object as follows. On correct, go forward 1 slide. On incorrect, go to slide 7. You perform those same steps for the other 4 question slides. As this game has a limited time, we need to add a timer that starts counting from the first question slide. In the Insert tab, click the Animated Timer button, then select Timer. You can style this timer as you want. Then, set its time by unchecking the Match Object Duration option, and typing another value. Make this timer show over multiple slides by right-clicking it and selecting Show Over Multiple Slides. If the time is over, the bomb will explode. Therefore, you add the On Timer Complete event and go to Slide 7 action to the timer. To make the game to be more realistic, you can add an audio file that imitates the sound of the timer to slide to. Just drag an audio file from the resources pane and drop it into the canvas. Then, make this audio play over multiple slides by right-clicking it, selecting play over multiple slides, and play to the end of project. Don't forget to set this audio as background music. In the Properties pane, Media tab. Check the Loop, Autoplay, and Background Music option. One more step is that, you drag the time bar of the timer and audio objects in the Timeline pane a little bit shorter. This action will prevent these two objects from playing automatically when the first slide complete. We continue editing slide 6. As this is the last question slide, you cannot set actions to move to the ending slide, slide 7, if the answer is correct. Therefore, you have to replace it with the following actions in the incorrect event. First, you add actions to pause timer and audio. As these two objects are played over multiple slides, we will use JavaScript actions to pause them. You write or copy codes to this box. These lines of code will be left in the description below for your convenience. After that, you hide the question title in the answer area. Show a congratulation image by hiding it at first. Then show it again. Lastly, play congratulation audio. Now we come to slide 7, which is the ending slide. There are three main actions that you need to add to complete this slide. The first action is to restart the presentation. You copy the play button from slide 1 and paste it into slide 7. Enter a new name for it. Then add the following events actions to it. On click, restart presentation. The second action is to pause the timer and audio. You continue using JavaScript as done in the previous slide. The last action is to add a bomb explosion audio file to this slide. You just drag the file from the resources pane and drop it into the canvas. Now that you have created Defuse the Bomb Game, you can press F5 or click the HTML5 preview button to preview the game.
Mission complete.
Thank you for watching.